As dot a craft as ever was seen was the Pernocchi lugger Evangeline, built for the swirl of the wild North Sea. Of the toughest oak and larch was she. Her sails and rigging and masts and all were fitted to stand what might befall in the roaring rage of an Orkney gale. Her skipper was built of the self-same plan, a rugged and storm-trained Banffshire man. Calm as a seabird, strong and brave, he would ride the ridge of the roughest wave. And his spirit and grit nerved all the crew. What the skipper would dare, they would forthwith do. But even the bravest of men may fail in the roaring rage of an Orkney gale. Season by season, for many a year, she swung to her berth at Stromsey Pier. The silver freight of her latest catch glistening down in a main deck hatch. But whether her luck was good or bad, a right good welcome she always had, and none dreamed that she would ever fail in the roaring rage of an Orkney gale. The Stronsy men and her sturdy crew forgathered as fisher folk all will do. Search the world, you will never find men of such single heart and mind. They meet and they part like brothers all, with a shake and a smile and a cheery call. Nor think of a day when they still may fail in the roaring rage of an Orkney gale. One year, when the work of the fleet was done, the skipper set sail on his homeward run, and the crew of the good Evangeline, waving their hands on the deck, were seen, whilst their voices ran back the old refrain, "Goodbye, good luck, we will come again." And who could tell that they ever would in the roaring rage of an Orkney gale? They all came back, but not as before, with a leap and a laugh to a Stronsy shore. They all came back, but wait, I will tell the fate which those gallant hearts befell. How the crew of the lugger Evangeline on the Stronsy shore again were seen. Alas, alas, 'tis a sad, sad tale of a wreck in a raging Orkney gale. Christmas was passed with its kindly cheer, and Hansel Day of the newborn year. And after a feast comes need and need, the fish must be caught and the children must feed. So out from Pernocchi the fishing fleet steered, whilst the wind to the deadly southeast veered. And woe to the craft that with it must sail in the roaring rage of an Orkney gale. The night came down like the fall of dew, not a star flashed out of the fearful gloom. Suddenly rushed the wind to the worst, with a bound from their nets the fisher fleet burst. Then by God alone that night were seen the lights of the poor Evangeline, as she drove brow down with her shattered sail in the furious grip of that Orkney gale. Past Burrahead, like a feather she flew, beyond will and skill of skipper and crew. They had done their best, they had done their last, for the breakers roared through the raging blast, and the billows swept over the groaning deck, leaving the lugger a crewless wreck, to drift without mast or sail through that seething scud of that Orkney gale. They all came back, but not as before, with a leap and a laugh to Stronsy shore. They all came back, but silent and still, like men who had yielded to God's great will. And the Stronsy folk remembered with pain, "Goodbye, good luck, we will come again. And prayed, Lord, may thy mercy never fail the fishermen's needs in an Orkney gale.